Take a look at this city's skyline. For the most part, these skyscrapers are made out of two things, concrete and steel, which are great for building, but not so great for the climate. But what if you were to add wood? Wood is one of the oldest building materials. It's made out of carbon sucked up from the air. So what would wooden skyscrapers mean for our climate? Steel and concrete take a lot of heat and energy to produce. Take a look at their carbon footprints. Well-managed timber, on the other hand, is kind of the opposite. For most of history, we couldn't build wood structures higher than a few stories. Until now, thanks to a new technology called cross-laminated timber. It's strong, simple to build with, and easy to make. So easy, I made some myself. I'm starting with these 2x6 boards, the kind of boards you find at Home Depot. Then they're cut, stacked Jenga style, and glued together in a press. In the end, you get sheets of wood kind of like this. Now, obviously, I'm not going to get very far here because this is tiny. The real stuff is made in big factories with high standards. But the point is, with simple materials like boards and glue, you can make towers. At least, that's what they're doing in Canada or Europe. But Susan Jones is trying to make CLT happen in the US. This is her CLT house. When she built it in 2015, it was one of the first in the country.
We like to joke that this is not a building, this is a carbon sink.
Take these two forests. These trees are sucking a lot of carbon dioxide out of the atmosphere and turning that carbon into wood. After 80 years, this forest gets cut and this one keeps growing. As trees get old, they start to suck up carbon a little slower, and some eventually die and decompose. Meanwhile, the cut forest is replaced with new saplings, and the carbon from the cut trees is stored in the lumber. But there are some big assumptions baked into this wood-fueled scenario. Let's say, for example, the forest we turned into lumber isn't replanted, or maybe it's unhealthy, poorly managed, or burns in a wildfire before it can be logged. And just letting a forest grow has countless ecological and watershed benefits that this accounting just doesn't capture. But the point is, under the right circumstances and at the right scale, tall wood buildings could be great for the climate. Many states in the West are trying to thin overgrown or diseased forests, which act like tinder for wildfires. A lot of those tiny trees wouldn't have had a traditional market. But with cross-laminated timber, you can put those waste products to work. Take this wall in Susan's kitchen. This middle layer came from a 6-inch diameter tree that was killed by a blue beetle infestation. A dead tree put to use as a binder layer.
If we do this right, and I can't emphasize that enough, if we do this right, then the forest will be healthier and a lot of that carbon's gonna be sequestered in these kinds of buildings and bigger scale.
Slowly but surely, the barriers surrounding mass timber are starting to come down. After Susan built her house, she was picked to serve on a committee to write new international codes for tall wood buildings. Tall wood buildings might sound like a fire hazard. Part of the committee's job was proving they're sturdy and fire resistant.
We built this two-story structure and then burnt it down 5 times, tried to burn it down. It did not burn down. The structure was completely intact after 4 hours of burning with no sprinklers.
Now, a supply chain is growing. Along with the number of CLT schools, churches, affordable housing projects, and offices, it's even being used to build Adidas's new US headquarters.
When you introduce concrete to the building technology, it was also a new technology. We're just introducing a new one, and it's going to be commonplace.
Cities are growing around the world. And maybe, if we do this right, the buildings themselves could turn into a climate solution.